Okay, there you go. Today, I'm going to teach you how to capture Zoom audio into our Vmix directly and the Vmix audio into our Zoom. Okay? But first, let us join a Zoom conference. Okay, the ID and the password. Okay, join meeting. Join without the video. Okay, there you go. In here, for us to feed an audio into the Zoom, we usually use the two options. Either we're going to use the mic in, we're just going to unmute this one, this microphone, or the other way is we use the share screen audio. Click share screen and then go to computer sound only and then click share. But the problem of this share screen is that you cannot anymore use your computer to play VLC, media player, or even the browser, because whatever audio that comes out in your computer will be fed into the Zoom. So that is why you cannot use any more computer to play any application or software. Okay, now I'm just going to stop this one. As you can see, in this Zoom, if you click this microphone icon, you can see line in and same as system. And the speaker, headphones, and same as system. Now, I'm going to teach you another way to feed an audio using the Vmix. Just remember this one, these items. Okay? Now, I'm going to teach you how to feed an audio from the Vmix directly into the Zoom. Okay? And how to capture the Zoom audio into our Vmix. Okay, the concept is like this. The Vmix video, we're going to feed it into the Zoom by using Vmix output or external two. While in the audio, we can use another method such as virtual audio cable. This virtual cable, we can use it in both input or output. The audio of the Zoom, we can input it directly into our Vmix, or we can use it as an output. For example, we have an audio from the Vmix, we can feed it directly into our Zoom. Okay, that is the use of the virtual audio cable. Okay, now we're going to download the virtual audio cable in the internet. Okay, now this one. So just click this one. And then, see here, download. So just click this one, and it will automatically download. Now, let's go to the download folder, and let us go into extract this one. Okay, there it is. Open it. We're going to install this one, setup X64. Okay, but first, before we install this one, let us go back to our Zoom. As you can see, in our Zoom, at first, it's only line in and same as audio in the microphone. And in the speaker, we have speakers, headphones, etc. And then same as system. Okay? Now, next, we're going to set up this one. Just right-click and run as administrator. You should set up it as an administrator. So, click run as administrator. Just click OK. Now, install driver. Okay? Install. Just wait for it. Okay, installation complete and successful. Okay, now just click OK. So we successfully installed the virtual audio cable. Okay, now after we install it, let's go back to our Zoom. As you can see, we have now additional item here in our microphone and also in the speaker, the cable input and the cable output. We can use both of these into our Vmix. Okay, now let's go to our Vmix. Let's go to the settings and then go to the audio outputs. Okay, here in the master output, if we click this arrow down, we can now see the virtual cable as well as in the bus A and bus B. There is already the virtual cable, and the bus B also, there is a virtual cable. In our master output, if we're going to choose the virtual cable. Just choose this one and click OK. And it will restart the Vmix to apply changes. Let's add now the video. Let's choose a video. Let's choose this one and click OK. And we cut it. We already have video and audio in our Vmix. Here in our Zoom, if we click the arrow up in the microphone icon, we can see now the virtual cable, okay? If we choose this one and click the unmute button, so whatever audio that is coming from our Vmix will be fed directly to our Zoom through the virtual cable. I will show you, as you can see here in the setting, audio output, and it's going to show also the Vmix, the Zoom. See here, this is the video and audio that is coming from the Vmix. It will be fed directly to our master output, and the master output we choose the virtual cable. Now here in the virtual cable and in our Zoom, we choose the virtual cable. So whatever audio output from the Vmix, it will be fed directly to our Zoom. As you can see, there is indication that we have received an audio that is coming from the Vmix. Now, see, what if we're going to feed a different audio to our Zoom from the audio that is coming from our speaker in our computer, okay? Now, see, so instead of choosing the master output, we're going to choose the default Windows playback in our master output. We can use the bus A and bus B. For now, we're going to use the bus A. Let's choose the virtual cable in our bus A. Just click this one and click OK. And restart. If we're going to open our audio output again, as you can see here, in the bus A, we choose the virtual cable. Okay? Now, here in our audio mixer, we can choose the... This is the master audio, and this is the bus A, and this is the bus B. So instead of choosing the master audio, we uncheck this one, and we choose the bus A. So that means the audio that is coming from this video will be directed to the bus A. And the bus A, and this bus A, will be fed in the virtual audio cable. Okay? Okay, now. Let's add another video to see the differences of the audio in our system. Okay, now see. Here, let's going to play this video. Okay, what if the audio of this video will be fed to our Zoom and this one will be fed to our computer speaker? Okay, so what shall we do? Okay, so now let's going to configure it. Okay, so let's go to our audio mixer. Okay, this is our audio mixer. I'll put it here. Okay, this audio is coming from this video. See, HD 1080p, HD 1080p. And this one, the audio of this one is coming from this video. Relaxing music, relaxing music. Okay, so we're going to uncheck the master of this one, and we're going to check the bus A. Okay, so that means the audio of this video will be fed into the bus A. Which is the bus A? Is the... Okay, the bus A, we feed it in the virtual audio cable. I hope you got my point. Okay, now, let's go to our Zoom. So if we click this one, see, the audio of this one was fed into the bus A, which is the bus A, we feed it also into the virtual audio cable, which is we feed it directly to the Zoom. So if we click this audio, click this one, if we click the audio of this one, so see, and we click the audio mixer, so the audio of this video will be fed into the master, and this will be heard to our computer speaker. And the audio of this video will be fed into the bus A, which is directly going to the Zoom, which is this one, the virtual audio cable. Okay, now see, whatever audio coming from here will be fed to our computer speaker. Okay, if I'm going to unmute this one, see, this one, there is no more audio that is coming from here into our speaker. See, there's no more audio here. So if I'm going to check to click this again, so we have audio in our speaker. If we click this one, see, okay, so no more audio anymore into our Zoom, because this is the bus A. Okay, now if we click this again, so we have already an audio indicator, meaning we have an audio that is fed from our Zoom coming from the bus A. Okay, if we click again, so no more audio, because the audio of this one is coming from the virtual cable, and this one is coming from the bus A. So if we click again, see, there is already an audio. While in our computer speaker, we have an audio that is coming from the master. See, if we click this one, so we don't have any more audio in our computer speaker. While in the Zoom, still, there is an audio. See, there is an indicator that there is an audio in our Zoom. Okay? This is the process on how to feed an audio from the Vmix to the Zoom. Okay, now let's do it in other way. The audio from the Zoom, we're going to feed it directly to our Vmix as an input. There is an audio from the host. The host is using share audio. Okay, now how to capture the audio from the Zoom into our Vmix? So what shall we do? I'm going to close this one first. Okay, now go to add input, then go to audio input. In the audio input, you choose the virtual cable. Click this one and then click OK. Okay, now as you can see here, there is no indication that there is an audio. Okay, now let's go to our Zoom. Here in our Zoom, the host is already feeding an audio to this conference. Okay, now go to our microphone icon, click this arrow up. Here in the speaker menu, choose the virtual audio cable. Okay, this one. Choose this one. So as you can see, there is already an audio coming from our Zoom. If we click this one again and we choose speaker, see, the audio is not present in our Zoom. We did not capture any audio. But if we choose this one and choose the virtual cable, we can see that there is an audio coming from our Zoom. Okay, so that's it.